Under the harvest moon, that's where I learned this happy tune.
It's an online event this year,
and we'll miss Don Gross's beer.
And for you,
First, I want to thank all of those who made heroic efforts to produce our service this morning, including Marty and Kim, Jill and Randy, with power outages that prevented them from having internet and power, so critical to producing our content for these virtual services. I also want to thank Dan and Carol, and Dave and Tammy, who let me work in their basements the last 3 days and treated me like a prince with drinks, snacks, and pizza. I also still do not have power or internet in my home. What my sister would call first world problems. On behalf of our minister, Reverend Dave Dunn, music director, Alex Peach, Interim Religious Education Director Melinda Mischick, I welcome you to the Unitarian Universalist Metro Atlanta North Congregation, which we affectionately call UUMAN. A liberal religious community, UUMAN is a member of the Unitarian Universalist Association. We are a community of young people and adults striving as best we know how to build on our deepest values to bring justice and compassion into the world. I am delighted to welcome those visiting with us online this morning. If you're interested in learning more about our congregation, please email membership@uuman.org. That's UUMAN.org. We are glad you're here, and we look forward to getting to know you. For more information on upcoming events, see the upcoming events section on the homepage of our website at uuman.org, UUMAN.org. Now take a moment to quiet yourself. Take a deep breath and a moment for yourself. Be here now, in this virtual space with each other, and prepare for our service.
Good morning. We join together to celebrate this dance we dance. It is a dance of life. It is a dance of death. It is a dance of finitude. It is a dance of infinitude. It is a dance of supplication. It is a dance of surrender. It is a dance of grief. It is a dance of grace. And it is a dance of love.
This week's chalice lighting is the monthly chalice lighting from the International Council of Unitarians and Universalists. These words are offered by Reverend Diane Rollert, minister in the Canadian Unitarian Council.
Welcome hearts. Come hearts that are open and hearts that are closed by trials and sorrows, loss and misgivings.
Come seekers, searching for answers, for respite, or a space to unleash your joy.
Here all are welcome. No excuses are needed, nor explanations.
Bring your whole heart, and let it be touched.
As we light our chalice, the symbol of our faith, this moment belongs to each of us.
UUMAN is a community where everyone's needs matter, and we have learned that caring is an act of faith. We may find connection in sharing the most profound experiences of our lives. If you have a joy or a sorrow that you would like to share this morning, please type it in the chat. I'm going to share two. One is a great joy for my mother, who at 94 has just returned home to her assisted living facility in Fort Myers, Florida, from 2 or 3 weeks now that she's been in rehab for her second hip repair surgery of her last few years. She has the best attitude anyone could ever imagine. After being a great mother to 11 children and countless foster children, she just is so happy to be alive and a great model and inspiration to all of us. And the second one is for Dan's mother. And she is not eating, Dan has told me. And he's quite concerned for her, but she has very good care where she is staying. And I'll drop one more pebble for all those joys and sorrows still too tender to escape the folds of our hearts. Let us keep one another in our thoughts for the coming week.
Hi, I'm Mike Chambers. Along with Mary Beth Stevens and Elizabeth Rohan, I teach junior youth religious education at UUMAN. It's a pleasure and privilege to teach these 5th, 6th, and 7th graders. Together every Sunday, we explore life's big questions, such as who we are and where we're going. We also explore UU principles and UUMAN's mission and vision, especially as they relate to social justice. In fact, we've been working on a special social justice project. Now our kids would like to share with you more about that project.
Thank you to everyone at UUMAN for donating blanket kits to Family Promise. We are the junior youth and we are grateful for your donation and we are happy to be making the blankets.
Thank you, UUMAN.
Thank you, UUMAN.
Thank you.
We have learned that we must be the change we want to see. We must be our faith in action. It matters that a church like UUMAN exists as a place to learn, to grow, and serve together. It matters that the work of our faith is lasting, that we make a difference to each other today, and that we make the world a better place for our for generations that will come after us. This morning's offering will now be received using the Givelify application.
They talked about it while soaking an unusually deep red tub at his rented house. How the constellations had gone out of their way to align so that their paths converge for a time in the redwoods, in a shingled cottage above the creek. It was all so perfectly temporary. He had easier hours at work. She, the willingness and freedom at midday, even some nights. Statistically improbable that their bodies fit together the way they did. And that the words he whispered fit seamlessly inside her ear. But isn't it written in the holy books? The gods do not like to dole out too much honey so as to not saturate the palate. Or the soul, which must be allowed its hungers. And this was honey by the spoonful. He played guitar and sang for her while she soaped her limbs. He peeled off her robe with his teeth while she read him his favorite poems by the last fire's flame. Perhaps it is a mercy to have limits. Isn't unimpeded pleasure almost unbearable? And isn't there always someone just outside the frame who has to pay? The gods allow us only a moment of indulgence, a little taste, right before, in their infinite and merciless wisdom, they take it back. Alondria Williams, who served as co-moderator of the Unitarian Universalist Association from August 2017 through June of 2020, passed away unexpectedly on September 23rd. She was an incomparable leader, a joyful presence in our movement, and we will be forever grateful for her legacy in our faith tradition. She was a member of the Tennessee Valley Unitarian Universalist Church in Knoxville, Tennessee, where she grew up. She was elected to the UUA Board of Trustees in 2016. She held a six-year term on the Presidential Search Committee, and she was also a founding member of the Black Lives Unitarian Universalism Organizing Collective. She will be missed, and may she rest in peace.
We are worthy, not because of what we produce, but because of who we are. We are divine bodies of light and darkness. You are not worthy because of what you offer, not because of what is in your mind, not for the support you give to others, not for what you give at all. We are worthy and are whole just because. And this great turning and this great pandemic and this radical readjustment and alignment, we are not disposable. We are needed. We are the very people that have withstood everything that has been thrown at us as a people. And as Maya Angelou would say, still I rise. We rise from the pain. We rise from the grief. We rise from the limits people place on us and the limits we place on ourselves. We rise to be the children and the ancestors. We rise to be our true selves in relationship to our families and communities, recognizing our liberating and whole selves, honoring them and others as we strive for abundant communities, abundant lives, abundant relationships, and abundant values and cultural manifestations. We are worthiness personified. I, you, we are worthy and deserve a life where we are not always fighting for our existence. Imagine what we could create if we were not always in the struggle. Imagine what we could envision if we could just be let to just go there. So tired of always having to resist, to fight, demanding, pushing to everyone that has the courage, the power, the ability to co-create what we want and need while rooting in what we can't lose and who we are. You are the visionary. You are the hope. You are our ancestors' dreams. No, you might not ever end up on some list somewhere, but you are on a list in someone's heart and mind. And if it is and how you move in the world so people can see by example, you are the embodiment of what we need. Thanks to all that are that embodiment. The embodiment not of productivity, but the embodiment of radical love, care, and sanctuary. It's time, y'all. Embodiment time. Embodiment, living one's values out loud. Let me, every day, live my values out loud. Let us every day live our values out loud, embodying our values, not a productivity quotient. Beyond productivity, past productivity, true embodiment, life.
Written in the Days of Growing Darkness, a poem by Mary Oliver. Every year we have been witness to it, how the world descends into a rich mash in order that it may resume, and therefore who would cry out to the petals on the ground to stay, knowing as we must how the vivacity of what was is married to the vitality of what will be. I don't say it's easy, but what else will do? If the love one claims to have for the world be true, so let us go on cheerfully enough, this and every crisping day, though the sun be swinging east, and the ponds be cold and black, and the sweets of the year be doomed.
Springs by James Schuyler. There is a hornet in the room, and one of us will have to go out the window into the late August mid-afternoon sun. I won. There is a certain challenge in being humane to hornets, but not much. A launch draws two lines of wake behind it on the bay like a delta with a melted base. Sandy billows, or so they look, of feathery ripe heads of grass, an acid yellow kind of goldenrod, glowing or glowering in shade, rocks with rags of shadow, washed dust clouds that will never bleach. It is not like this at all, the rapid running of the lapping water, a hollow knock of someone shipping oars. It's 11 years since Frank sat at this desk and saw and heard it all. The incessant water, the immutable crickets, only not the same. New needles on the spruce, new seaweed on the low tide rocks, other grass and other water. Even the great gold lichen on a granite boulder, even the boulder, quite literally, is not the same. 2. A day, subtle and suppressed in mounds of juniper enfolding, scratchy pockets of shadow, while bigness, rocks, trees, a stump, stand shadowless in an overcast of ripe grass. There is nothing but shade, like the boggy depths of a stand spruce, its resonance just a thin scream, a mosquito's ascending. Boats are light lumps on the bay, stretching past erased islands to ocean and the terrible tumble, and London, rain persisting, and Paris, changing to rain. Delicate day, setting the bright of a young spruce against the cold of an old one hung with unripe cones, each exuding at its tip gum, pungent, clear as a tear, a day tarnished and fractured as the quartz in the rocks of a dulled and distant point, a day like a gull passing with a slow flapping of wings in a kind of lope, without breeze enough to shake loose the last of the fireweed flowers. A faintly clammy day, like wet silk, stained by one dead branch, the harsh russet of dried blood.
This morning, as part of our service of remembrance, we will light a special candle of memory in honor of those who have gone on before us. May their spirits dwell with us as we worship together. On your screen, you will see the names of those who have gone on in the past year. We will now draw forth their spirits through the reading of their names. Mary McCarthy.
Wayne Hilton.
Daniel Neal Jr.
Brian Tootle.
Jeffrey Patrick Bragg.
Barbara Knapp.
Ann Holiday Nestrick.
Paul Collins.
Mary Kathleen Dunn.
Dorothy Soule.
Tom Worth.
Carol Mara.
Al Kapeskas.
Sandy Jones Manafi.
Jack Portman.
Doug Stump.
Raymond Galea.
Craig Olson.
Ruth Bader Ginsburg.
Alondria Williams.
Estella Smith.
Joseph Ben David.
Levelon Wall. May we remember the very best of who they were and what they embodied, and may we embody that essence in our lives. May their beloved spirits hold us, guide us, and sustain us through the year to come. May it be so. Now on your screen, we'd like to honor and remember anyone special to you who is no longer with us. If you forgot to send us this information, please feel free to include their names in the chat. We hold in our hearts all of our loved ones who've gone before, yet whose names are not shown here. May they be with us here in spirit this morning. We no longer share the touch of their hands
and the sound of their voices and the sight of their smiles.
We extinguish this flame to mark their deaths.
Yet the memories of their special character live on in our lives.
Their spirits remain with us and a part of us. Let us give thanks for the gift of life.
that brings us joy, peace, and strength of heart.
Let us give thanks for every person and for all beings
whose life speaks to us words of hope and affirmation.
We give thanks especially for those
in whose memory we gather this day.
We now light the candle to symbolize their presence in our lives.
On the day when the weight deadens on your shoulders and you stumble, may the clay dance to balance you. And when your eyes freeze behind the gray window and the ghost of loss gets into you, may a flock of colors, indigo, red, green, and azure blue, come to awaken in you a meadow of delight. And when the canvas frays, and the crag of thought and a stain of ocean blackens beneath you, may there come across the waters a path of yellow moonlight to bring you safely home. May the nourishment of the earth be yours. May the clarity of light be yours. May the fluency of the ocean be yours. May the protection of the ancestors be yours. And so may a slow wind work these words of love around you, an invisible cloak to mind your life.